My name is Bishop Shelton Fabre, and I currently serve as Bishop of the Diocese of Houma-Thibodaux. Those of you in the Diocese of Houma-Thibodaux are aware that our new priest assignments have just been announced. And you may indeed be wondering, how is it that the bishop makes these decisions? Or is there a process? Or how does all of this happen? Let me explain what occurs. During the month of December, I have a one-on-one meeting with each priest, just to ask, how are they doing? Have they gone on retreat? How is their spiritual health? How is their physical health? Just an opportunity to meet with them, to ask them how they are doing, and to let them know of my concern for them. In January, looking at some of the notes from those one-on-one meetings with priests in December, where one of the questions is, would you like a change of assignment? With that information, I then look at what are the projected needs of the diocese? Will there be any retirements? Will there be vacancies in parishes for other reasons? Who are the priests that have indicated to me that they are open to or they would like a change of assignment in July? After that, around the month of February, usually, the priest personnel committee begins to meet with me. What we do is we try to create a slate of assignments. We try to look at the unique needs of a parish and the unique abilities of a priest, and we come together with a proposed slate of assignments. Now, who's on the priest personnel committee? There are diocesan officials on that. There are priests of various ages. There are some of our international priests. There are priests with many years of experience. There are priests with fewer years of experience. But the variety on the personnel committee is intentionally designed to make sure that, to the best of our ability, we know each priest, and we can discuss the many gifts that he brings to the priesthood on the personnel committee. Now, I want to stress that the personnel committee and I together, we draft a plan. And once the committee and I come up with a slate of priests to fill the various needs in the diocese, then I begin communicating with the different priests on that slate. I ask, are you open to going here? And we discuss that as a possibility. Depending on what the priests say about the proposed change that is lifted up before them, there may be edits that are needed. And so I go back to the personnel committee and I simply say, here are the results of my conversations with the priest. Through prayer, through discernment, through talking with the priests, through interacting as the personnel committee, we do it all together. I want to stress how much I love each and every church parish in the Diocese of Houma-Thibodaux. Every church parish and every ministry that has a priest is important to me. We, and I do mean that we, the personnel committee members and I, we rely on prayer, we rely on our insights of the different priests and the needs of the various parishes, and we do the best that we can. It's a very challenging ministry, as I'm sure you are aware. No one priest possesses all the gifts. And when priests change, parishes receive the benefit of the gifts that that priest brings. And it also reminds us that it's not about the priest. It's about our Lord Jesus Christ. It's about the ministry of Jesus Christ that the priest wishes to convey to those entrusted to his pastoral care. So how do we make priest assignments? I don't do it alone. I rely on my conversations with the individual priests. I rely on the personnel committee. Perhaps mostly, though, I rely on prayer, my own individual prayer, and the prayer that you, the people of God in the diocese, continue to lift up to God for me and for all of our priests. And so I thank you for welcoming the priest in your parish. In a particular way, I thank all of you who will be welcoming new priests to your parishes. Know how much they desire to serve you, and know how much I am grateful that you receive them and welcome their priestly ministry. God bless you.